majority of the work, and then somehow, from what I've read, what you say is that then all of a sudden it becomes more controlled.
I think they sort of work more when I think less about it, and I mean, other artists will talk about that pie notion of just not thinking or overthinking it, but just letting things happen. And I think when I am surprised too at what happens, then I think that's potentially a more successful pace.
Mm.
It's getting to the point where there is a particular time in a piece where it's like I just know that it's finished. And I think if I did any more to it, it would lessen the pace. That feeling when I'm really confident that I've nailed a piece completely is really quite amazing. And that's actually what I kind of like to work. That's why I like to work this way, because when you get that, that's the best feeling.
So what makes a painting beautiful then?
To have that tension or that edginess where things aren't completely resolved, but you could see it sort of going further, but this is the right point at where it's kind of, it needs to stop. Several at a time, because I think, especially now with the way that I paint, things happen really quite quickly, and it sort of then takes time to catch up visually to what's happened. And I don't, because there isn't a process as such where I know what the palette's going to be or which bit I need to paint next, or because there is no start or finish as such, I always work on a few works at the same time, because then they can just be around the studio, and in my periphery I can sort of still see them, and I think they filter through, so you're visually acquainting yourself more with them. So then you kind of know what to do next, or know what not to do next, or know to leave them alone. Shape, and it's a lovely shape to experiment with, and I just thought that it would be interesting to sort of see what happens with the composition. And I've tried to paint it exactly the same way without thinking much about it and sort of seeing how the piece evolves on its own, but it's so much harder with a round piece because everything does seem to happen radially. And when I was moving it around on the easel, the drips were going in all directions and so much harder to control, which makes it so much better for, it makes it easier to make sure that I'm not controlling it, which is what I'm trying to do, and that was kind of making sure that that wasn't happening.
So it's more challenging.
Totally. Thank you.